Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and entertaining simple. This is the third video in my video series of redoing our small bathroom up here on the second floor. This is my kids' bathroom, and if you want to see the other videos of how we organized and decluttered the linen closet and also the drawers and the medicine cabinet in here, please check out the iCards above. Today I'm going to show you how we decluttered and organized under both of these sinks. This bathroom is just for my daughter. She's very lucky. She's very happy about it. And she's very excited how it's coming together. We will still be painting and putting some accessories in here. Used to have the bath supplies here and then the cleaning supplies there. So we got rid of a lot of bath supplies. And also, I am moving the travel toiletries to underneath my sink in our master bath. So we'll see how that fits. I might have to get rid of a few things. So here on the left is completely just for her mani-pedi stuff. She has had this organizer here specifically for nail polish. She likes the Essie brand and she loves doing her nails. She loves doing her own pedicure. Now, we used to go to the nail salon like every month ever since she was 2. And of course, once she turned 13, it was no longer $5. It was the full price. So we have stopped doing mani-pedis at the spa every month, probably in the past maybe 9 months to a year, because we just don't have the budget for that anymore. So we had invested in this, and this was probably like $25-$35 at Walmart. It's the brand Homedics. It's got a few brushes, but she likes to soak her feet in there, and she does, you know, she does her own spa. 2 command hooks that I had put here on the side for the cord to wrap around so it would be neater that way. So I just have to fix that, but it worked well. She has the clear base coat here. She has a couple of the Zoya brand. I think that was from Ulta, but everything else is Essie. And the best place that we have gotten Essie nail polish is at CVS when we have a like $5 coupon or $3 coupon, or like, you know, one of those 30% off on a single item, or the beauty stuff is on sale. So we wait for those sales to get her Essie nail polish. Here's a closer look at that. So she organized it, I see, from dark to light. And then the 2 Zoyas in the back. This used to have a different contact paper. We have this new one. It's from Target. It's taupe. We love the design. She's really liking the space a lot. And then she did this mani-pedi kit years ago. She decorated that. And it's basically like a toolbox. I think we got this one from the Container Store. You know, the toolbox is more like industrial. So this is a little bit cuter, and it's all plastic, and it opens up like that. Even a tackle box you can use, cotton balls, and then these, you know, like separators, the different tools. Even here is a foot scrub, files. She has a few more nail polish here. I think she wanted to keep these and wait till they're all empty. Here's even a cuticle remover, another kit. These are cream cheese containers. You can see from the Container Store, $1.99. And she just put some stuff in there. I could fit more stuff if I need to, but for now, this is what we're wanting to have in there. So by the way, this is the new rug I got for her. It's Nate Berkus from Target. And then on this side, I always have cleaning supplies. Every bathroom has a cleaning caddy, so it's just more convenient. I used to just have one, and I would take the caddy to each bathroom when it was time to clean the bathrooms. But I decided to go ahead and invest. It's not very expensive at all to put something like this together. All my cleaning caddies pretty much have the same things. It's got an all-purpose cleaner, toilet bowl cleaner, a tub and tile, glass cleaner. This is a hard water cleaner. It's a hard water stain remover. And then we have this brush filled with dishwashing liquid. That is for the tub. And then I always have 2 types of sponges. One is for the sink and one is for the tub. Cream cleanser here. Over here is a little mason jar with toothbrushes and toothbrush holders. That's for the tub, the sink, and then I think this is the baseboards. Yeah, there. So I just like to separate the toothbrushes for when I want to get into those little nooks and crannies. And then up here is just a command hook with a large binder clip for the cleaning gloves. And I like to do this under every sink. And then here are 3 plastic drawers. It's a, you know, one unit.
And up here we have her mineral Dead Sea bath salts. She adds that to her recipe for her eczema scrub. And then here are six chamois that I got from Costco. The ones at Costco are a terrific price, so they last a long time. They're probably the cheapest you will find anywhere. I have six of them. One is for the mirror, one is for the sink, one is for the tub, another for the toilet. I usually use two of them for the toilet area, and then an extra one, let's say like the tub needs extra wiping down or the toilet does. So I have six there. And I prefer these versus the different microfiber cloths that I've tried. They definitely hold so much more water and they do well in the wash and dryer. So these have been my choice as far as using them for cleaning stuff. With these drawers, I wanted to label them because it's basically random stuff in here. These have bandanas, they're red and blue, and I have had these for 5 years. They were actually for my son's birthday. He had a Nerf party, so they had an obstacle course. Everyone brought their Nerf guns. They had also a Nerf gun fight. It was a lot of fun. I have used them for other team building activities that I've done through the years. Off lotion, calamine, and rubbing alcohol, which is pretty much straightforward. Is exactly what's in there. And then the reason I label this specifically is because there are stuff that we don't use very often, but when we do need it, I'm like, where is that, right? This has aloe vera, petroleum jelly, AND, and tenactin. I think that's pretty straightforward also. All the stuff you see labeled there is here. I could always put little, you know, drawer dividers in here or drawer containers and keep that from, you know, moving around, but it's fine. That is what is under my kids' bathroom sink. You can see it's very decluttered. It's organized. We have only the essentials in here. Let me know in the comments below what are your essentials to put underneath the bathroom sink. If you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you.